Put on my robe and glory, shout and tell them my story. Good old gospel singing. Let's all stand once again. Take your hymn books. But I'm not going to be leading this one. We have a special song leader that's coming up. One that if you've been around here for a few years or maybe back on Rockman Circle, you would remember it. I've asked, and I'm going to turn the baton over, if we can say, Brother David Stevens to come up here. Now, how many used to be under his leadership when he leads the congregation? Raise your hand, okay? Okay, you've got some supporters out there, Brother Dave. And I think you're going to be leading one of your most favorite hymns. Why don't you tell them what page, and we'll get it started here, buddy. All right.
Page 415, Victory in Jesus. First and third standard. All right, all together now. I heard an old story, how a Savior came from glory. How he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his praise to come.
Taking up the offering, I want to. I have a special guest, Pastor Tom. They asked me to introduce, and I've actually never met this man before, but they asked me to introduce him. And I understand that you guys grew up together. You probably haven't seen him in probably, 40 years, probably, it's been since he's seen this guy. I understand you guys spent a lot of time together, and you went hunting together and fishing, and you actually created a class and taught classes together. And he is a pastor now of a small church up in the foothills in North Carolina. And if you people would help me welcome a longtime friend of Pastor Tom's, Pastor Buckshot.
Hey, how y'all doing? Hey, do you want him right there? Hey, how doing? Hey, Pastor Tom, good to see you, buddy. 40 years. Wow. That's something else, buddy. They give you the padded chair, did they? That's a pretty nice get-up you got there, moon pies and Pepsi. They got you right. Good to see. How y'all doing? Good to see y'all.
Hey, Pastor Buckshot, buddy. Give him a hand. Pastor Buckshot,
hey.
Thank you.
Well, you think this is a Carolina Panther game or something?
Well, it's good to have you, Pastor Buckshot.
It's good to be here, buddy. Good
I've never met you
again.
Before.
Yeah, well, it's been 40 years.
40 years since you've seen Pastor Tom.
Some of these people have been here 40 years, haven't they?
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
it.
Sure have. I understand that you and Pastor Tom have been hunting together before.
We've been hunting. We used to hunt all the time together. Sure did. In fact, we went hunting just 40 years ago.
You did, really?
Just 40 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, we was out. He shot 42 and a half ducks, that Pastor Tom.
Pastor
did.
Tom, that's great.
Sure
give
did.
Him a hand, Pastor Tom, 42 and a half ducks.
Well,
that's amazing.
I have to tell you, it wasn't that great a thing.
Oh, really?
Well, we's actually out at the park, and they just walked right up to him. He let them have it right there.
Pastor Tom, you don't need to say that.
That's Pastor Tom.
I thought maybe you guys did some real hunting. You know, like you're out in the woods, just you and your dog by yourself, just sitting out there in the woods.
Hey, you got a dog.
And you're sitting out. Yeah, I got a dog, but I thought maybe you guys had had
you
your dog.
You got a dog.
And sitting out. Yeah, I have a dog. So.
That's all right, buddy. You all right with me. I like a man who's got a dog. Look, a man who's got a dog.
But anyway, you're sitting out in the woods with your dog. You're
hey, what kind of dog you got, buddy?
A chihuahua.
That ain't no dog.
It is, too.
That's a rat.
It is not.
I'm talking about a man's dog. A real macho Rambo type dog. Say, that's the kind of dog I got. He's a killer.
What's his name?
Look.
know, we started 40 years
not
ago.
Not all about what I said to him. Listen, don't get 60 Wait. Years old, you can't remember what happened.
Okay, hang on.
It's so much fun being together once again as a ladies' trio. Being with you girls again. It's been a long time since we've been together as a ladies trio from First Assembly. Long time ago.
40 years ago we began to sing. You remember?
Oh, how I remember.
Remember? 40 years ago we began to sing together. I think Jeannie and I were singing.
Yeah.
But no, Betty sang first.
She started singing first.
All right. Betty sang first as soloist, and I'd play for her. Then Jeannie and I, I don't know how we became singing together, but we did it with Jeannie.
We did.
And somehow or another, we all got together, all the three of us, and we've been together ever since. 40 years.
40 years, Virginia, that's been a long time. But it was a lot of fun. And
it was.
Still could be.
Remember practice sessions?
Oh, oh Lord. I remember practice sessions every Saturday without fail.
Jeannie, remember that?
Come rain or shine. Didn't make any difference
right.
What happened. We had to be there at 2 o'clock rehearsing at the church for the next day, Sunday. But we couldn't stay together forever. We practiced several hours.
At 5 o'clock came, Jean. What happened?
We had to stop because we had to go pick up Tom's shirts at the cleaners to wear
every Saturday.
That's
every
true.
Saturday.
She said, oh, no, I got to get Tom's shirt. He don't have a shirt to wear
now
in the morning.
I must be there by 5. They close at 5. I must That's stop true. Rehearsal at 5. So we did.
Remember how we used to pick our songs every Saturday when we were practicing, girls?
I remember.
40 years.
We'd start leafing through the book and then see one we thought we knew and or we liked.
They liked to sing.
And then we'd sing them and then go on to another one and just sing all evening, just one song after another.
Oh, remember this one?
Oh, I like that one.
Yes. A lot of times the people would ask us to sing certain
right.
songs, you know, and we would try to fit that in too, but we would always try to pray and ask the Lord to lead us in the right directions to what songs to be sang. And normally, it would go right with the service. Do you remember?
Right. Yes, I remember.
Do you remember? It would just go right with the service, how the Lord had the Lord move. It really did.
There's a lot of songs in that book, Virginia.
There really are.
And then some were sang by sheet music that's not even in there. That's true. And some, if you remember, we would, if we found the song we liked and it was on a record, we
right.
would listen to it over and over. Virginia could just pick up and play anything in any chord. And so we would learn the song from the record.
Then we all sang together, and then I had a part there. What key was written in. I'd always have the keys written out up there.
Well, this does bring back memories.
Good
memories.
She was such a perfectionist, and we had to get our part just right, even though it sounded right to us. It didn't to her, so we'd have to go over the same line over and over and over.
I'll tell you something else she did.
Why?
She would sing all three parts.
Right.
If we didn't know it very well, she would sing our part for us until we learned it.
And then we too
something else.
Which one could reach the high notes, that's the one who took the lead.
We did swap around.
Not because of anything hard if we couldn't reach the notes.
Do you all remember when we get through singing, how we would pick out the songs that we wanted for the next Sunday morning or Saturday, whenever,
mm-hmm.
and then we had some dresses made alike. My mother made us some pink dresses, and we were invited to go out to different places to sing, but we would get to wear those pink dresses. We thought we were something then. And we'd sing at different occasions, the Dumiums meetings.
Yeah,
and
one time we went up to Burlington for a Betty Baxter meeting.
Right, I remember that.
WM thing.
We wore our pink dresses.
We did. And then we sang while the other ladies would go around and get their lunch. And so when they all got their lunches and we could sit down, we didn't have any food left. So we sang for our supper, but we didn't get any supper. So we laughed about that. We were very serious when we sang and put our whole hearts into it. But yes, we did have a lot of fun because we were fellowshipping together. That we were as one. We sang as one, and we laughed and had a good time. But yet we were very serious with what we were doing.
Bless his holy
found me.
Thank you. That's the very first song we ever sang together.
I was guilty with nothing to say, and they were coming to take me away, but then a voice from heaven was heard that said, let him go. And I should have been crucified. I should have suffered and died. I should have hung on the cross in disgrace. But Jesus, God's Son, took my place.
I'm gonna get carried away when I get carried away. to get carried away. When I get carried away, I'm going to get carried away. Carried away. When I get carried away. Amen. Thank you. God bless you.
Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you stroll down the Golden Avenue. There are mansions left and right, and you thrill to every side, and the saints are always smiling, saying, how do you do? Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you realize your worrying days are through. You'll be glad you were not idle, took time to read your Bible. It's a great, great morning for you.
I had a dream, and now confess I headed to away.
To meet me was an angel at the great pearly gate.
St. Peter said, why, hello there. Where have you been?
I've got your mansion ready, so just come on in.
And then he rang for an angel to work at the guide.
And then he spread his wings a time or two and learned how to fly.
Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you stroll down the Golden Avenue. There are mansions left and right, and you thrill to every side, and the saints are always smiling, saying, how do you do? Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you realize your worrying days are through. You'll be glad you're not idle, the time to read your Bible. It's a great morning, what a happy day.
Had a dream, and now confess I hated to away.
To meet me was an angel at the great pearly gate.
St. Peter said, why, hello there.
Where have you been?
We got your mansion ready, so just come on in.
And then he rang for an angel to work at the guide.
And then he flapped his wings a time or two and learned how to fly.
It's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you stroll down the Golden Avenue. There are mansions left and right, and you thrill every side, and the saints are always smiling, saying, how do you do? Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you realize your worrying days are through. You'll be glad you are not idle, the time to read your Bible. It's a great morning, a great morning.
Jordan stormy banks I stand and cast a wishful eye to Canaan's fair and happy land where my possessions lie. I am bound for the promised land, I am bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land, promised land. At the river where bright angels' feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing from the throne of God. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows from the throne of God. Throne of God, God, lay down my burden, down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. Gonna lay down my burden, down by the riverside, down by the riverside, riverside.
voice say, come up higher. John never lived. Wrote about the seed of God.
While in spirit praying, John turned around to see. Hey, is that voice that he had heard? It's what it seemed to be.
No special favor to ask. When I was a little girl, I lived in the very back door of the Concord Tabernacle. I was about 4 years, 5 years old at that time. And I started going to church there, and Tom's parents, Pastor Whedon Sr.'s, were the pastors there at that church. And I went to Sunday school every day. The neighbor next door really started taking me to church there when we moved there. And as I grew older, I loved to play. I began to play the piano. I'd hear things. I'd go home and try to play them. And Loyette played the piano at the church, so I would go over there. When I would hear her playing, I would go up to the end of the piano, and I would stand there and just watch her play. As long as she would play, I would stand there and watch her. It's probably they wanted to send me home many, many times, but I was in their back door just about every day. And I would go home and try to play just like Loyette. And that's how I really learned to play, by listening and watching her play there. And growing up there and then to Tabernacle, until they moved away, I was 10 years old when they moved away. Well, I started playing in church there when I was 10 years old. And then later on, they moved to Gastonia. And then when they came back to Concord, Roy and I were married, and I was pregnant at that time when they were going to start a new church here at the theater down there. Well, we began to go down there, and being pregnant, I got pregnant, and I was really, really sick at that time. But I wanted to go, so I would go as much as I could, but that place smelled so bad. I mean, it was bad. But we began to go, and then when we got into the church, I began to play the piano at the church there then. And at that time, I wasn't working. Randy was little. But when I got a job at the Concord Telephone Company, I would come to church almost up for hours and run back to work and play for funerals. And I played in church all my life.
The young lady that you have just seen, all of you know her very well. Donna and I, we have been here now for 8.5 years. And you know, you look across this congregation tonight and you see beautiful people. And, you know, the music department, we just want to take a special moment here and to honor this young lady that you've just seen. She knows nothing about this. But, you know, ever since I've been here, there's not been a time when I couldn't call on her, just like all of you have before in the past years. And when she said she would take off of her supper break to come and play, she has done that many times. To take care of funerals for me, I don't think but maybe one time in 8 years that she couldn't work it out. And if she'd have to take her lunch break at 2 o'clock to come and play a funeral, she's always been there to play for us. And from the music department, Virginia, would you please come up here? Where is she? Where'd she go? There she is up there. Come up here. And amen. Amen. We love you so very much, and we wanted you to sing all your songs before we did this because I knew what was going to happen because I know this lady. But that's right. But you know, this church, what I have seen, is made up with tremendous people who drove the buses today and and work so hard, and when we need someone to help build something, you're there and all. But from the music department, Donna and I, we really wanted to say thank you to Virginia. We can say this to a lot of people, but this is one person who has been so faithful and stuck behind us and always here and do whatever we ask her to do. And I tell you, it's tremendous because, you know, it's hard to schedule funerals, you know it? And just don't cooperate, right, Pastor Tommy? Just something. And we can call on her at the last minute, and it's just been so wonderful. And we wanted to say thank you since it's kind of a music night, okay? God bless you, Virginia. You may be seated. This morning on our video, you saw a quartet that was brought up from an album that was one of the most favorite quartets around here, I understand, from the beginning, called the Sherritt Brothers from down in Atlanta. Well, we flew them in, and they're doing... Sorry about that. But we have one of their favorite songs that y'all used to listen to. The guys have worked it out. I've Got Confidence.
When trouble is in my way, can't tell my night from day. When I'm tossed from side to side, like a ship on a raging tide. I don't worry and I don't fret. God has never failed me yet. Troubles come from time to time, but that's all right, I'm not the worrying kind. 'Cause I've got confidence, God is gonna see me through. No matter what the case may be, I know he's gonna fix it for me.
Well,
I've got confidence, God is gonna see me through. No matter what the case may be,
folks wonder how I smile, even though I'm going through trials. How can I have a song when everything is going wrong? I don't worry, I don't fret. God has never failed me yet. Troubles come and go and come. That's all right, I'm not the worrying kind.
I've got confidence, God is gonna see me through. No matter what the case may be, I know he's gonna fix it for me. Case, baby, I know he's gonna fix it.
down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Lead me, Lord, I'll follow. Anywhere you open up the door. Let your words speak to me. Show what's wrong and make it right. Day star shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Lord, I see a world is dying. Wounded by the master of deceit. Groping in the darkness, haunted by the years of past in your eyes. I pray, Jesus, shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Oh, lead me, Lord, I'll follow. And make it right. Day star shine down on me. Let your love shine through me in the night. Day star shine down on me. Let Jesus shine.
for ransom so that you can join that band.
Saints will rise.
Saints will rise. Saints will rise.
Saints will rise.
Saints will rise on that hallelujah morning
when we hear,
that trumpet sound.
And lonely nights filled with despair caused me to long for someone to care. Then I heard Christ say to me, this promise I've made, oh, I am with you now and forever, be not afraid. I'll never be lonely again, never again. For I have opened my heart's door to him. So I'll brush away my tears and forget my foolish fears. I'll never be lonely again, no, never again. If you're longing for a friend, loving and true, turn to the Savior, he waits for you. He will do the same for you as he did for me. He'll never leave you, never forsake you, trust him and see. You'll never be lonely again, no, never again. If you will open your heart's door to him, though just brush away your tears and forget your foolish fears, you'll never be lonely again, never again.
we have a great leader in Tom and Betty Whitten. And we're going to just sing some old-time gospel songs here at the end. And the choruses of these songs will come up. And you might already know them, and you join right in with them. So we'll put this together about an hour ago, okay, or 2 hours ago. So here we go from the beginning. Heaven's Jubilee.
Sun glad morning, we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me, joy's ours to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints arrive, headed for the Jubilee yonder in the sky. Oh, why singing, oh, why shouting on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, Savior in the sky. Seems that now I almost see all the same today, rising for the Jubilee that is just ahead. In the twinkling of an eye, change within to be, all the living saints will fly to that Jubilee. And oh, what singing, oh, what shouting on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, 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 when we meet our blessed Savior in the sky. And oh, what singing, singing, oh, what shouting, shouting on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the sky. Oh, they tell me of a home far beyond the sky. Oh, they tell me of a home far away. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. Oh, the land of cloudless day. Oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise.
Oh, they tell me of
an unclouded day. Oh, they tell me of a king in his beauty there, and they tell me that mine eyes shall behold where he sits on the throne that is whiter than snow, in the city that is made of gold. Oh, the land of cloudless days. Oh, the land of unclouded skies. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. And oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. Oh, there's some glad morning when this life is o'er. I fly away to a home where God's blessed the shore. I'll fly away. Oh, by and by, I'll fly away.
Pastor Joe!
Just a few more weary days and this, I'll fly away. To a land where joy shall never end, I'll fly away.
By and by, I'll fly away. Oh,
I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away.
When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
hallelujah, by and by,
this has been one of the most marvelous weekends I think I've ever spent. And praise God. We've had so much to celebrate about, and God has helped us to have a great celebration. And I believe all of us have enjoyed it, and we are thankful to God for all that He's done these last 40 years. Tonight has just been awesome. Thank you, folks, so very much. God bless you. I'm so glad you got together and did those old songs and got the old groups together. It's just great. Thank you so very, very much. I have so many people to thank tonight, and I don't know really where to begin. In fact, I'm not going to, because I would leave someone out. But my wife and I, Betty, come and stand here with me, so when I talk, they'll know I'm talking about you too. Rather than I'm saying I. But we have never experience such an outpouring of love as we have this weekend, and I want to tell you it has been quite humbling. We've enjoyed it, wonderful talent and the beautiful music and all of that, but we've been humble this week more than I think we ever have been. I said to someone, you folks sure know how to kill a preacher. Because now, you know, I'll just work my fingers with the bone after all these good things that you have done. And we are just grateful, we are humbled, and we are thankful. And we say thank you to all the people, not only to those who have had a part in making this the weekend that it's been, but the people. If it were not for the people, there'd be no church. You are the church, as you well know. And we are very, very grateful for you. All the people during the last 40 years who've crossed our path, and we've crossed their pathway. God has placed us in so many unique places in these years, for which we are very, very grateful and thankful. Thank you for coming last night. Thank you for coming this morning. And thank you for being a part of the activity at the Activity Center today with the dinner. That was marvelous, was it not? So well organized, so well done. And what good food there was, and enough for everybody. It was a great, great day, and I think many of us had a lot of fun. And I know that I did, and I'm sure that Betty did. Had a lot of fun. Now,
I enjoyed it very much. The food and the fellowship, everything was wonderful.
Okay. All right. When I was a young guy, I had always wanted to ride a motorcycle.
That must have been a nightmare.
I've always wanted to do that. And I remember when I was about probably 13 or 14 years old, I had a neighbor friend who was a little bit older, and he had a motorcycle. And so he told me he would take me riding and teach me to ride it sometime. And I was looking forward to it. I knew I wasn't old enough, didn't have a license, but we were going to do that anyhow. And so one day when we didn't think that Mother was around anywhere, I got on that motorcycle and we took off. And we were probably a couple of miles from home, and I heard a horn blowing. And I looked around, and it was my mother. She had caught us in the car, and she whipped around us, and I have never seen in all of my life such a terrible expression as she had on her face. And she waved for us to pull over, and he pulled over, and she jumped out of the car and said, "What in the world you think you're doing? You get in that car, I've told you," and on and on. And I got in the car, and that was the last of my motorcycle riding. But God is a good God. And He saw my heart. And there's a friend in this church, in this congregation, sitting up on the left here, Raymond Griffin. And he called me a few weeks ago, and he said, he calls me Rev. He says, Rev, the people's kind of got a joke on you, and they're doing things and talking about this, pulling your chain and so forth. Why don't we pull a joke on them? And I said, well, what is it, Raymond? And he told me about a motorcycle. He said, we'll just get a sidecar on it and put Betty in there, and you can just surprise everybody. Well, how many motorcycles I destroy, Raymond, before I... Only one? Well, he was a brave man. And I said, Raymond, I never have done this. I didn't tell him at first. It's been a dream of mine. But I said, I've never done this, but I really would like to. Boy, I was wanting to. And so we met at a parking lot over here. I won't say where. And he put me on that motorcycle and told me just how to do it and let me go. And before I made it back to him, I had wiped out big time. Big time. Tumbled out in the field, rolled. I thought I was dead and woke up and found I was alive. Betty even felt sorry for me. But anyhow, I got back on it and only destroyed one motorcycle in all the learning process. But he helped me, and I began to ride that one, drive it, and then he brought one with a sidecar on it, and that was when Betty's day came. And when Raymond told me this, and I hung the phone up and went in the house and found her, I said, Betty, we're going to do something to surprise everybody on the 14th. And she said, pray tell me what? I said, I'm going to drive a motorcycle, and you're going to be in the sidecar. She said, what are you talking about? You have lost your mind. I am not going to be in any sidecar. I mean, that's just soft that I'm demonstrating. And I said, but Betty, Raymond is really wanting us to. He's going to be brokenhearted if we don't do this. He's got such a high thoughts about this, and he really wants us to do this, and you're going to disappoint Raymond. You know he's our friend, and he's been in the church a long, long time, and you don't want to disappoint him like that. And, yes, I will. I don't care who it is. And so finally Raymond talked to her, and he talked her right into it. I mean, it was a piece of cake. She said, okay. And now today when she got out of it, she said, you know, that was fun. So the Lord may answer fully my dream before it's all over about the motorcycles. And so thank you, babe, for riding with me today.
Oh, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. I was so glad you didn't wipe out, though, because I could just see the thing, you know, you turn in the curve, and me in the sidecar on this side, and us going over, and you just falling over on top of me. Yeah. I didn't like that idea at all. And but you did well. I must admit, you did well. And I don't think he wiped out any, Raymond.
And you see, she's always that way in the car. When we're about to have a wreck, or she thinks we're about to have an accident, the car is always on her side, and she's the one that's going to get killed. Always. Tonight, we are very privileged to have some more special guests. We've had special guests last night, and special guests today in services, and now tonight again, we have some special guests that have really had a part in this church. And I think I could just say the Cookman family. And so if the Cookman family would just come to the platform right now, we'd all like to see you. Come right onto the platform. The Cookman family, all six of you. Yes. God bless you, Carol. Love you. God bless you, Randy. Sister Cookman, God bless you. Brother Cookman, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. These people have all had a part in First Assembly. The first week, you may be seated, the first week that we opened the church in 1958, June the 14th, I believe it was, my father preached the first week. I don't know if it was a full week or a part of a week. And then the next week, my mother preached the same thing. I think it was a part of a week. And then I'm not sure it was the third week, but just shortly thereafter. Was it the third week? I think it was the third week, Brother Cookman says. He came. He pastored in Charlotte at the time, and he came over and preached the revival the third week. and didn't take any money. He just did it free. It wasn't much money to take, but but he didn't take any money. He just came and gave his time and his effort, and we will never forget the effort and the labor that you folks put in those first few days of this church, Brother Goodwin. Thank you so much. Would you like to say a word? We'd love for you to.
I just want to say it's one of the greatest investments that I ever made. Little could I have known then what is now, but it is so apparent that the hand of the Lord was with you and on you, and that God had called you to do this. John Ashcroft has given a definition for a leader. He says a leader is a person who selects noble objectives and pursues them with such intensity that others are motivated to follow. And when I thought of that definition, the person who came first and foremost to my mind was you, Pastor Tom, because during these 40 years, we have watched you select noble objectives and pursue them with intensity. And it's a marvelous thing to think that last night was the fulfillment of a marvelous dream. I know that that is so. And what a joy it is for us to invest it, to have invested our lives in just a small way, but then our children too, in the wonderful ministry. You have actually put more into us than we've ever given to you. And we want to publicly, before all these people, say thank you.
Thank you, Brother Cookman. That's not really true. I had the privilege and the honor of working with Dr. Cookman for several years. He served as the district superintendent, and I served as a district secretary treasurer. And the information, the knowledge, and the wisdom that this man put into my heart, God would just have to show that, because I have no way of showing that. He helped me so much. You see, I came here in 1958, Betty and myself. We started the church. 4 years later, I was elected the secretary treasurer. We left the church. My parents came as pastors. And Pastor Jones was a superintendent at that time. Soon after that, he resigned and went to Gastonia. And then Brother Cookman was elected as superintendent. And we traveled the state many, many miles, late at night, many, many times, talking about the things of God. And during those times, this man put in my heart more than you will ever know. Brother Cookman, I will always be indebted to you. Thank you so very, very much. You've been so kind to me. But even perhaps more than that, he gave to us some wonderful co-laborers in the work of the Lord. The first one was his daughter, who was the wife of Randy. And Carol, God bless you. I remember a few years ago, you stood on this platform and told us about a trip that this church was giving to us to Hawaii. Do you remember that? You don't remember that? Do I have that all wrong? You remember it.
I remember the trip. I don't remember.
Well, we have pictures of her with the lay and all, and she put it around Betty's neck. Well, I just want to tell you they did that. You remember that? Okay. Well, we went to Hawaii. That was how many years ago? 15 years ago? Yeah. Well, last Sunday, 2 weeks ago, they put another lay around Betty's neck. And they told her she could take anybody she wanted to. When I got her on that motorcycle, I said, "You are taking me to Hawaii." So we're going. But I just remembered that you put the lay around her neck the first time. Randy came to be on staff with us in 1970. He wasn't married. I picked out his wife for him, did a lot of things for him. Helped him a whole lot. And Randy, we just appreciate so much. Of course, he got married while he was here, married Carol, of course, and then she became a part of the church and was committed and did so many wonderful things. A great singer, great musician, plays the piano and organ and sings beautifully. And Randy, he tried to sing some. He did a good job. But he did a lot for the Lord while he was here, and we appreciate that. And you folks have had a part in this church, and we want you to know we appreciate it so very, very much. Want to say a word?
It was our honor. And Tom, I, in the years that I've been gone, have learned to love and appreciate you even more. thank you for all that you put into my life. I trust that somehow I can bring back to my mind all of the things that I did and that I've seen you do. I just would like to say to you all, cherish not only Tom and Betty, but the entire presence of God that you have in your service. I leaned over and spoke to Carol last night, and I said, is it just me, or is it just this much different than the last time I was here? It's always been great, but the presence of God, the presence of the Holy Spirit was fantastic last night, and it's something that I trust you will cherish. You need to visit a few places if you want to appreciate it. I know Pastor Tom doesn't want you to visit many places, just as I don't want my people visiting a lot of places as well, but it opens your eyes, and it lets you know how much you have. And you have a lot. You have a great deal here. And Tom and Betty and your pastoral staff. And I just encourage you to love them. Thank you for the years that we had here. They were great. We loved them. As a matter of fact, God began to deal with us about 3 years to leave. Before we left, it was hard to make that decision. We love you folks, those of you that we know, and those of you that we haven't met, we love you as well. But we have many wonderful memories here. Our children, our boys especially, still call this home, really. Thank you for the privilege of being here and sharing this weekend with you. It has been a tremendous inspiration to me, and I thank you for it.
How long did you?
That was your 17 years.
17 years.
Amen. I think this, I forget what they called him, this guy that came out first tonight. I think it was you he went hunting with, not me.
Buckshot.
Buckshot, right. Yeah. Now, where are you now, Randy?
I'm at Edenton.
Thank you. God bless you. God bless you, Carol. And over here is a fine young couple. We called this young man Butch when he was here, but his name was Noel. And since he left here, he decided to pick up his name and not be called Butch any longer. There was a time I was called Tommy, and I decided to be called Tom. And so that's sort of the way Noel has been. And Noel was here. When did you come, Noel?
1974.
You were here how long?
8 years.
8 years. He was a youth pastor, and he was a great youth pastor. Noel, have a word for him. And Gay, his wife, of course. God bless you. Gay was a secretary, fantastic secretary, great secretary, this, and a great preacher's wife. And God bless you. Amen.
Well, it was at the Shoney's right down the road that Bob Kilpatrick, who was from California, we said, my name is Butch and Gay. He said, you know, out in San Francisco, you might not want to do that. So I did have a real name, and I decided to use it. But around here and in Raleigh, where we live now, if anybody says Butch, I say, you've been to Concord, and you've met somebody that I know. And Zach and Andy still call this home. We call this our home church. Zach's here tonight. Andy's working. And Travis and Brandon and Brittany and all of them are here too, I think.
All of us, Sam, all you children of the here.
All the kiddos. Where
are you?
Pastor Tom wants you to stand.
Yeah, stand. I'm asking you to stand.
There they are, one up there. Where?
Oh, there. Okay.
There, right. There they are, right back there. Okay, good. Yes.
I just want to thank Tom and Betty for letting us be here. I would echo what my father said. Tom and Betty invested much more into our lives than we could have put here. And thank you all for letting us be here and call this home. It's an awesome place, and we're so honored to just sit here and see what God has done and cherish, like Randy said, your pastor and what God has done in this church. It's awesome, and we just thank God for it. We love you. Thank you.
We love you.
God bless you.
Amen. Thank you. God bless you, Gay.
Amen. Love you.
Amen. Praise God. Well, just a second. I have something, a little something for you. We have today given out some telephone directories as a gift.
Did you folks get one?
Well, you can, okay. You can get another one, and we won't be spending.
Did you folks buy it?
I need to get one. And also a directory, a 40th anniversary directory. So we're going to give you both one. Thank you. God bless you, folks. We love you. We love you. God bless you. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We have been celebrating what God has done for the last 40 years here. I think I mentioned a few weeks ago in at least one of the services, I forget which one, that I'd been thinking at that time about the celebration and the time that we would have together to thank God for all he has done and to give him the glory and honor. But during those moments of fault and remembering the past, the Holy Spirit brought great conviction to my heart about not the things that we have done as a church, but the things that we did not do. For he showed me that day that there were many, many things that we could have done if only we had done them, if only we had believed God. I repented that day and asked God to forgive me, for I know there's nothing impossible to those people who believe God. And that same day, God began to deal with my heart about the future. And somehow he put into my inner being a desire and a vision to see this town changed. Not just 2,000 people or 3,000 people or 4,000 people. I'm talking about a city. And you may say, that's too much. A city can never be reached for God. All things are possible to those people who believe God. And if we will do what God has called us to do, we will touch this city for God before the next 40 years. I can assure you that. And I say tonight, would you stand? And would you, with your pastor tonight, make a new commitment, a new dedication, new consecration, no matter what it takes, that you would do what you can. My mother's not here tonight. I'm sure she preached herself out today 3 times. Oh, she's here? Oh, she was way back there in the back. She made it. Okay, good. All right. But what she said was good all morning long, all 3 services. But in the last service, she shared something that really touched my heart, and I don't think I will forget it anytime soon. Someone asked a question. They said, you can tell how much you are concerned about the lost and about gaining this world's goods by asking yourself, if someone were to say to you, I will give you $1,000 for everyone you lead to Jesus Christ. If you would respond to that and go out and start working and trying to get people to be saved and to be a follower of Jesus Christ to get the $1,000, then according to what she said, you better look at your inside. You better inspect what's going on the inside. That's the wrong motive. And I wonder, I really wonder, if we could offer you $1,000 per soul, how many people could be won and talked into even First Assembly by next Sunday. I'm not judging. I'm not trying to judge. I just think that we're in this world and we probably have more of the world in us than we think. I think it may be a great motivation. God forgive us. And may the blood of Jesus, the sacrifice of Jesus, be the motivating force to send us out. Folks, a night is coming when no person can work for Jesus. And I beg you, I plead with you tonight, I sincerely ask you tonight, put your life on the line for Jesus Christ. I'm going to ask all the present pastors and their wife or mate if they would come and stand behind Betty and I. And Dr. Cookman, would you come back? And would you pray for this staff? And would you pray for this congregation? And God will open our eyes anew and afresh and impart to us a vision like we've never even dreamed about having. Thank you.
Let's pray together, shall we? And as we pray, would you pray and offer your life a sacrifice, a living sacrifice, as Romans 12 invites us to do. Our Father, we thank you for 40 years of vision and hard work and faith. 40 years of believing you and seeing your mighty hand, of knowing that your voice has been clear and that we have followed the vision that you have given. And we come now, Lord, to this celebration of 40 years and recognize that tomorrow begins the next 40 years. We thank you for the past, and the only thing between the past and the future is right now. And right now we want to renew that commitment. We want to renew our whole dedication to you tonight. That in the glory and joy and flame and blessing of the past, we may rise and recognize that the best is yet to come. Hallelujah. That your promises are even bigger. That your provision is even greater. That the power of God only lies at the very point of our faith to believe you for even greater things. Now, our Father, you've placed in Pastor Tom's heart a vision that Concord in Cabarrus County may be changed for the glory of God. An awesome vision, an awesome challenge, an awesome task. But, Lord, you are well able to take us and do what you will and do what you want. Hallelujah. If you can take 12 men and change the world, you can take this great congregation of people and change this county for the glory of God. Hallelujah. We ask you, Father, because we present our bodies as living sacrifices to you tonight, holy, acceptable unto God, a reasonable service, that we may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Hallelujah. Let your mighty power flow, we pray, tonight into us, that we'll rise tomorrow with a fresh new vision and touch of heaven in our hearts. Hallelujah. Oh, God, put your hand new again tonight on Tom and Betty, on this wonderful staff of ministers, on this whole congregation, because all of them, Lord, are your ministers out in this community, touching relatives, touching people, touching fellow workers. Oh God, we ask that your power and presence will fill them and in such a way, Lord, in such a glorious and marvelous way that they'll be surprised themselves by what you do through them. In the name of Jesus, we pray and we expect and believe you for it. Amen. Amen. All glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Thank you, Brother Goodman. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Pastor Don, you sang some old songs tonight, and I thought you didn't know them. But do you know the chorus, Bind Us Together? Okay, would you lead us in that? Would you join hands? Let's all join hands.
Bind us together. Bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together. And bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken.
love you. We love you. I want to say it again. We love you. I want to say to all of you, the only way that we have ever found that we can really serve God is by serving people. You're important, most of all, to God. But I want you to know you're important to First Assembly. We need you. We want you to be a part. Over 130 ministries with the 900 volunteers, we need you. There can be more ministries, and there can be more volunteers. Have a great week. God bless you. One more time as we go.
Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together.
Meeting in the morning at 6 o'clock. That's before breakfast for some people. 6 o'clock in the morning, prayer meeting right here. Thank you.